Hey everyone, so today we are going to see the proof of this theorem. So we have seen in my earlier lecture, if you have not seen, link is there in the description, that if you have two subspaces, then their addition is again a subspace, its scalar multiplication is again a subspace. If I take intersection of two subspaces, that's again a subspace. And we saw an example where union of subspace need not be a subspace. So I have given an example in that lecture, and here also I will give you the example, but this is a different example. So my suggestion is you see that example as well, and I will give an example here as well, that why the union of subspace may not be a subspace. Okay, so I will come to that example later on, but let's try to see the proof. So since the union of subspace is not a subspace, so question is when it is a subspace. The answer is, so it's a subspace if and only if one of the set is contained in other. So if this condition is satisfied, then only we say that the union of subspace is a subspace. So let's go for the proof first. Okay, so suppose, so if W1 is contained in W2 or W2 is contained in W1, what we want to prove? We want to prove that your union is a subspace. Well, the proof is, this side is very easy. So suppose we have that one of them is true. So suppose your W1 is contained in W2. That means what, a W2 is a bigger set and it contains W1. So when you take the union, what is the union? It is nothing but W2 only. What is union? You take the elements of W1, you take the elements of W2. But elements of W1 are already in W2. So therefore, when you take the union, I'll get W2 itself. I don't get anything new. So W1 union W2 is nothing but W2, and W2 is a subspace that is given to me. So therefore, the union is also a subspace. Okay, other way, suppose if W2 is contained in W1, then what will be W1 union W2? Now since W1 is the bigger set and it contains W1, so when I take the elements of W1 and W2, so as soon as I take the elements of W1, elements of W2 are automatically coming here. So therefore the union is nothing but W1, and W1 is given to be a subspace, and union is nothing but W1. Therefore this is also a subspace, both are equal. So if this is a subspace, this is also a subspace. So if one of them is contained in other, then union is always a subspace. Good. Now let's go for the other way, and for other way we will go by contradiction. So suppose union is a subspace, then what we want to prove? Either one of them is true. Either this is W1 is contained in W2 or W2 is contained in W1. So suppose neither of them is true. Suppose W1 is also not contained in W2 and W2 is also not contained in W1. Then we should get a contradiction. Okay. Now what does this imply? Your W1 is not a subset of this. That means what? There is an element in W1. There is a vector in W1 such that that vector is not in W2. This is not contained, right? So if this is my W2 and W1 has to be something like this because it is not contained. So there is an element in W1 which is not in W2, right? Similarly, if this is W1 and W2 is not contained, so W2 is not something like this. W2 will lie outside, something like this. So this is my W2. That means what? There exists an element in W2 which is not in W1. So this is, you can visualize with the help of the Venn diagram. So my W2 is not in W1 means what? There exists an element or a vector in W2 such that your B bar is not in W1. Okay, now your A bar is in W1 and W1 is a subset of W1 union W2. So A bar is in union, your B bar is in W2, and W2 is also a subset of W1 union W2. So therefore your A bar and B bar, they are element of the union, but union forms the subspace. So this implies what? Your A bar plus B bar belongs to the union, because it is given that the union is a subspace. Okay, now let's arrive at the contradiction. So this is what we have. A bar plus B bar is in the union. And what are A bar and B bar? A bar is in W1 but not in W2. B bar is in W2 but not in W1. Okay, now the addition is in the union. This means what? Your A bar plus B bar is either in W1 or it is in W2. Suppose it is in W1. Now A bar plus B bar is in W1 and your A bar is also in W1 and W1 is a subspace. So if I subtract, then their subtraction is also in W1, right? But if I subtract them, what do I get? I get B bar is in W1, which is not possible because B bar is not in W1. That's what our B bar is. So therefore, your A bar plus B bar can't be in W1. So this implies what? Your A bar plus B bar has to be in W2. But if it is in W2, then if B bar is also in W2. So if I subtract A bar plus B bar minus B bar, and since W2 is a subspace, this subtraction has to be in W2. But again, this implies that A bar is in W2. But what is our A bar? Our A bar is such that it is not in W2. So even this is not possible, and hence we get a contradiction. So we assume that none of the subspaces are contained in another, and due to which we got A bar and B bar, these two elements. And from this two we got that addition is in the union. But if addition is in the union, it has to be in one of them. But what we are getting, it is neither in W1 nor in W2, which is not possible. Thus, our supposition is wrong. So what was our assumption? That suppose both of them, that means W1 is not contained in W2 and W2 is not contained in W1, this is wrong. That means what? Either W1 is contained in W2 or W2 is contained in W1. Okay, so that's what the proof is. Now let me give you an example where union of subspaces need not be a subspace. Well, I have already given an example in my previous lecture. Link you can find in the description. But that was a different one, and here I will give you a different example. So just look good the example. It's good to know more and more examples. So let the vector space be set of all 2x2 matrices. Let W1 and W2 be set of all symmetric and skew symmetric matrices. We have already seen that this forms the subspace. Now question is union a subspace? Answer is no. So you take an element X from W2. As you can see, this is a skew symmetric matrix. Take Y from W1. As you can see, it's a symmetric matrix. You can verify. Okay. So since X is in W2, so X is in the union. Y is in W1, so therefore Y is in the union. Okay, so your X, which is in W2, and W2 is always in the union. Your Y is in W1, and W1 is also in the union. So X and Y are in the union. But what can you say about the addition? Is addition again in the union? Answer is no. Because what is W1 plus W2? It is nothing but 1, 1, 1 minus 1. As you can see, if you take the transpose of this matrix, you will not get the same matrix again, and also it is not a minus of A. So this matrix is neither a symmetric matrix nor a skew symmetric matrix, and therefore this matrix is neither in W1 nor in W2. Hence the addition is not in the union. Okay, this has to be my X plus Y. So we got two vectors from the union whose addition is not in the union again. Therefore, union of two subspaces in general need not be a subspace. So I hope you understood this lecture. If yes, do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.